When I first saw these videos and photos on Instagram, I was like, wow, this gel polish is the bomb. And I immediately wanted to buy it, but I couldn't find it anywhere. I started searching, where can I get this? Russian bloggers started posting the photos and videos with these gel polishes, and I was like, all right, now I'm going to get it. But unfortunately, I figured out that most of them are from the Ukraine, and shipping from this country is quite hard. I didn't have any gel polishes again. And you know, I just kept searching and asking, do you guys have these reflective gel polishes? Where can I get them? And everywhere I've seen the same result. Not available, already gone, sold out, and so on. In our days, most of the products are really easy to get, right? You just click on it, you just order, and then you have it. But this one was so hard to get that it feels, you know, different. Like I got something really exclusive and precious. So I'm super excited. Let's try it.
Hello guys, Anastasia here. It is time to do new nails on my right hand. So today I will be doing gel overlay with my left non-dominant hand. First, I'm going to clip off the nails. I already filed them shorter after a couple weeks. By the way, it's been 2.5 months, I believe. I don't really remember when I had nails for such a long time. So I file off as this is polygel. Then I shape my natural nails. I decided to do an oval shape because this is one of the most comfortable natural nail shapes to have, so I will have pretty short nails this time. Then we push back the cuticles with a pusher. Are you familiar with the feeling when you haven't been doing something for a while and you really miss it? That's exactly what I feel like now because I haven't done my nails in quite a while. Next step is e-file prep. I'm using flame bit with red abrasive mark. The speed is 14,000 rotations per minute. We're done with the prep. It feels so weird to look on my naked nails because normally I get to see them whether they have extensions or overlays. Apply dehydrator, non-acid primer only on the free edge area for a better adhesion, and a thin coat of gel base coat. Wow. Yeah, swear to God I'm with it. I don't see nobody in my lane is quite go get it like me. Wow. Applied base coat on my nails and cured it for 30 seconds in LED lamp. Let's do the color. I have two colors, silver and golden, and since I prefer silver tones, this is going to be the main color, but I'm still trying the gold one on the thumb. This gel polish has a really loose glitter, so in order to apply it and to have enough glitter from the first coat, you are not supposed to press on the brush too much. So once you touch the surface with the brush, then you do a very light touch and proceed. Because if you will press too much, you will not get enough glitter and you will need to do at least few layers. But if you do the light touch, as you can see, even the first coat is pretty intense. I cured the first coat and I'm going to apply the second one, of course, because we always want more glitter and more sparkles. Plastic clip is helping me to push back my puffy sidewalls because for me this is the only way to apply the color on myself, but luckily I have it only on couple nails, like my index finger is kind of okay and I can apply the color without it. So these are two coats of silver and let's try the golden one on the thumb. This color has a very similar texture, so I would recommend to apply it the same way. And by the way, I can tell that this gel polish is based on clear gel, which means do not be afraid to apply it a little thicker than usual. It's still going to cure really well and it's definitely not going to wrinkle or anything. This is the first coat, do not forget to cure it for 30 seconds. Then we apply the second coat, which doesn't have to be very thick by the way, and cure it for 30 seconds as well.
then we seal it with the top coat, cure the top coat, and we're almost done. Are you ready? This is how it looks in their regular light, beautiful silver sparkling nails. But once we turn the lights off and have a little bit of light from your phone, this is what happens. This is how it looks when we have even less light. Look how beautiful and pretty the lighting is. Are you ready for more? This is what it looks like when I'm using a flashlight on my phone. So pretty, and this is the exact look I was looking for when I was hunting to get these gel polishes. And by the way, this is how it looks in the bathroom once you turn the lights off and turn on the flashlight on your phone again. It also looks really nice when it's like half dark, but I couldn't catch all the looks on the camera. Let's take a look at some other nail goodies I got from Born Pretty. Stamping plate. First things first, you need to take off this thing from the stamping plate in order for it to work. So if it's blue, it's not going to work. And oh my god, my reflection is like from some horror movie, like a maniac is chasing me. Anyways, this design is really cool and I think it's gonna look great on some neon colors. Let's try this one. I'm using black stamping nail polish by Born Pretty as well as the stamper. Wow, awesome. Let's try something different. I have an ombre tip. By the way, I really like to buff the surface before I do it. And by the way, if you were wondering if you can use a stamping nail polish on top of gel polish or gel nails, yes, you absolutely can do this. I tried it already a few times, but only if the design is not covering the entire surface, just like this one's. It worked great. As you can see, even the thin and tiny lines are showing up. It was my review of Born Pretty products, reflective gel polish and stamping plate.
This is the look that we get. I think it's awesome, but I have to be honest with you, it looks so great only through the camera. When you use this light from your phone, then you turn on the camera and this is where we see the magic. But I think it's still kind of cool because you can have a couple of those, record this photo and video and post it and use it for attracting new clients. Let me know what do you think, and do you own any reflective gel polishes and which brand? Do you like it or not? Because I really like to get some reviews on those. Thank you so much for watching. If this is your first time here on my channel, consider subscribing as I post new nail art tutorials and product reviews just like this one every week. See you in my next one. Goodbye.